Good morning. Good morning, everyone. I'd like to share something with you, and it reminds me of this song that goes, "You're all I need to get by. He is all I need to get by." Okay, so I was reading Watchman Nee, and I was thinking about, you know, the scripture that says that we are complete in Christ Jesus. I was also thinking about the Lord's Prayer, and I'm going to tie the two together briefly. Just give me a moment. I want to read this one scripture, though, okay? And this scripture is found in Colossians 1, 16 through 20. Every time I put my finger up like that, I want you to say all, okay? I don't hear you, but I'm just going to trust that you are doing it, thinking it, or saying it. It goes like this. "For in him were all things created in the heavens and upon the earth, and things visible and things invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. All things have been created through him and unto him, and he is before all things, and in him all things consist, and he is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have the preeminence. For it was God's good pleasure of the Father in him that should all the fullness dwell, and through him to reconcile all things unto himself, having made peace through the blood of the cross. Through him, I say, whether things upon the earth or things in the heavens." Colossians 1, 16, 20, you know, all things in it, all things, by him all things consist. He made all things. There's nothing that exists had not Christ in, Christ made it. And, you know, Christ and God and the Holy Spirit, they're a part of the triune Godhead, and they were all in participation with it. And in him, we live and move and have our very being. And we know that, that he is our peace. Jesus is our peace. He broke down the wall of partition that was between us and God, you know. So if we say that, "God, give me peace," we're forgetting that we don't have to have the thing of peace when we have peace. He is our peace. So peace is a person. I mean, you could have it as a thing, but we're talking about the life-giving peace, the peace that passes all understanding. It's not a piece of peace. This is peace because it's in his being. It's who he is. He's life, and he is peace. He's the God of peace, you know. So don't go for the things, because he is all we need to get by, and we need him every hour. So there's the scripture that says, when the disciples says, "Teach us to pray," and one of the things that he taught them to do is say, "Let your kingdom come, let your will be done." The world, the that you establish, the place where we should dwell as Christians, let that be downloaded into our life. Let your kingdom come. Then it goes to say that the kingdom of God is not a thing. It's not something you can consume or put on. It's not meat or drink. It's not something that is tangible that you consume and then you're done with it and you got to go back for it. Like food, you got to keep. But watch this. It says the kingdom of is not meat or drink, but it is righteousness. What? Is it the thing righteousness, or is it the being that we are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus, that he is our righteousness? So that place that is in him, God is trying to say, get into this place. Not in the knowledge of good and evil as something, a thing, but get in the place of life that in me, my life in you is your righteousness. He is our righteousness. So the kingdom of God is not, it is righteousness, which is not a thing, because that's in Christ Jesus. And he says, peace, the kingdom of God is righteousness. Peace is the thing, peace, but no, in this place that I'm now telling you to dwell in me, is peace. because I am peace. I am the God of peace. He is our peace. He has broken down every wall of partition that was separating us from God when we were at enmity with God because of the sin in the garden when Adam chose with the life, with the tree of life right there. He chose the knowledge of good and evil, the self-sufficient, the thing instead of the life-bearing personhood of Christ. So get up off of that thing and go for the real deal. Don't get the knockoff. Get the peace that passes all understanding. Get the personhood. He is our peace. And then it says, the kingdom of God is not meat or drink. It's righteousness, peace. And then it says joy. Wow, in the Holy Ghost. We know that in God's presence is fullness of joy because he exudes what he is. And he is saying, now tap into me and get this lasting joy because I am in you. And the joy of the Lord that is me is your strength. That's why Jesus could go to the cross and count it all joy because he is joy. He doesn't see, he sees more than we see. When we get caught on seeing and judging life and death and lack and insufficiency, in Christ, there's life. There's liberty and there's freedom and there's peace and there's joy because we are complete in Christ Jesus. All that we would ever need, it is in him. And we're going for the thing of life, the thing of joy, the thing of peace, instead of the peacemaker, the personhood of Jesus Christ. We got to get to that revelation of allowing what is to be. Even as we are processing it through our reality, the truth of what is. That's why we are becoming known, to become known as we are known, as I am seeing you through the blood of Jesus, it complete in Christ Jesus, you know. So even on our journey to accepting our healing, know that healing is not a thing outside of us, but it is inside of us and it's available. It's Jesus. It's God himself. It's the God of peace, who has also given us the same power that raised Christ from the dead that allows the, but to get this, we have to die daily. We have to be crucified every day. But it has to be in Christ Jesus. So I'm crucified in Christ Jesus, you know. I'm dead and buried, hidden in Christ Jesus, because it has to be in him, you know, because he is now in us. And so it's like an agreement. It's be it unto me as you've spoken, you know. So I'm dying daily, I'm crucifying this flesh, so then I know that I'm going to be quickened in this new spirit, and then I'm going to be raised, you know, to this new place, and I'm going to then be seated in Christ Jesus with a new perspective and a new vantage point, a new place in all of this is in him. And to be in him is life, and to be in him is all that I need, because I am complete in Christ Jesus. What does that scripture say? By him all things exist. You know, and then I just read the scriptures. It sounds like a rapper, because, you know, he said, I'm this and all things, you know. And here he says, for in him all things created in the heaven and upon the earth, things visible and things invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities, all things have been created through him and unto him. So in him we live and move and have our very being, you know. And so our very being in him now has access to the peace that he is, the joy that is his presence, and the righteousness in him that he gives us, that we're the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Be encouraged to not go for the knockoffs, but go for the real deal. To not let the world and the world patterns that are just natural in the Adam nature, to let you go for things, and even go for things in your doing instead of in whatever you do in word or deed, do it in his name. Do it where there is life. Do it where there is life. Do it where there is, so you don't come up empty because you're doing things in your strength. Be encouraged. get off of that thing. Don't go for the knockoff. Know that we're complete in Christ Jesus, and let us move to a revelation to know who we are in Christ Jesus. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.